Welcome. And thanks for taking a break with me today. We are going to do a little bit of movement. We're going to take some time to breathe, lay down, relax, and have a good day. So let's stand ourselves tall and let's get ourselves up. Just a nice comfortable position. We're going to get our feet under our hips and take the arms up big and tall. Big breath in. We're going to exhale the arms down to the side. We're going to inhale up again. This time as we exhale, taking it over to a little side bend. Then inhale, rising up. Exhale, coming down to the side. And inhale, rising up. Exhale, scratching your back and then reaching to one side. And inhale, coming back up with a big reach. Exhale, scratching your back with the other side, taking that little reach. And then inhaling back up. Take it all the way down to the floor, touching your toes, walking up those shins. We're going to come down, planting both hands as we step back into our plank. We're going to set that nice plank position. We're going to pull the hips back and up into our down dog. And then from here, we're going to come back into our plank, stepping our left foot up into our lizard. We're going to take our hand inside and put it on that front foot, locking the big toe down. We're just going to turn our torso. We're going to come back to center. We're going to lower our back knee and press that hip. Just gently, we'll come back through and open up with that outside hand. And then come back down. We're going to straighten out the back leg, keeping the hips square. Turn the torso. Come back to center, lower the knee. Gently press the hip. Come back through, outside hand, nice big reach, and back down. One more time, we'll straighten out the back leg, turn the torso, come back to center, lower the knee, press the hip, and then come back through, outside hand. Plant that hand, we're gonna take the hand off the front foot, straighten out that back leg, step back into our down dog again, reaching those hips. We're going to come back into our plank again and step that other foot up. Inside hand is going to lock that front foot down, keeping the big toe down. Hips are square. We'll turn the torso. We'll come back to center. Gently lower the knee. Press the hip. Come back through. And then the outside hand will reach up. And then we'll come back down. Straightening out that back leg, keeping those hips square. We'll turn the torso. Come back to center, lower the knee, press the hip. We'll come back through, outside hand. And then one more time, we'll come down, straightening out the back leg, turning that torso, coming back to center, lowering the knee, pressing the hip, back through center, big reach, outside hand. Good, we'll take that hand off that front foot, straightening out the leg. Step it back into our down dog, reaching those hips. We're going to come back into our plank, nice and strong through here. We're going to lower the knees, then we're going to lower down to the floor, bringing those hands forward so the forearms come flat and the elbows are tight. We're going to push down a little bit into the forearms, pushing down with the toes. We'll inhale, reach through the crown, and then exhale back down. Inhale, reach the crown, and then lower down, and then inhale, reach the crown, and then exhale back down. We'll slide both hands into the chest. We're going to take one arm out to the side, pressing into the floor. We'll open through that side body as we press down to the ground, and then we'll lower down. Pressing through that straight arm, we'll press and open, and lower down, and one more time, press through that arm, press and open, and lower down. We're going to switch hands, so the other hand comes in, pressing into the floor with that straight arm, press and open, lower down, pressing that arm, press and open, and lower down, and one more time. Press and open, and lower down.
at this time, we're gonna bring the hands under the forehead. We're gonna rest the head down like a nice little pillow, pressing the toes gently into the floor. We're gonna squeeze our right heel into our glute. We're gonna pull our ribs in so we get that good engagement. Lifting a knee up, just holding that position, squeezing that heel towards the glute, keeping the ribs in, and then lowering the knee, extending the leg. We're gonna press down with the toes again, bring the other heel in, ribs, lift the knee, holding, lower down, extend, and then bring those hands back into the chest. We're gonna pull the shoulders forward, pull them back, pull them forward, pull them back, and pull them forward, and pull them back, pull the ribs in, push to the knees, up into the down dog, setting in that nice strong down dog position. Let's press the heel and hold. Press the heel and hold. We'll come back to center, into that nice plank position as we lower the knees to the floor. Nice little tabletop. We're gonna tilt the pelvis, reach through those abdominals, and then we're gonna roll the pelvis into the spine, rounding our body. We'll come back to neutral. Take the right arm to the sky, we're gonna thread it through. And then from here, holding for a breath or two, and then inhale, rising back up, planting that hand. Take the other side up, and stretch, thread that arm through, holding for a breath or two, and then rise back up, big stretch. Good, plant that hand, set that table, cat-cow, tilt to the left, reach the abdominals, roll into that cat, come back to neutral. We're gonna walk our hands up our quads, keeping the toes curled under. We'll take the arms up big and tall. We'll bring those hands down to the hip. Squeeze the glutes a bit, setting those ribs. We'll pull the elbows back. Exhale, round the shoulders and neck. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. Inhale, open. And exhale, close. This time, big reach, big open. We're gonna exhale, forward fold, back into our table. We're gonna curl the toes under, extend up into our down dog, and then come back into our plank, stepping our left foot up into our lizard again. So we're gonna come down, we're gonna lower that back knee, we're gonna press the hip, we're gonna come back through into that nice twist again, outside hand. We'll come back down. Rest that hip, come back through, outside hand, back down, press that hip, back through, last time, outside hand, and plant that hand, grip the floor, straighten out the leg. We'll step back into that down dog, setting those shoulders good and strong. We'll come back into our plank, pushing through the floor. We'll step that other foot up. Nice and square in the hips, we're gonna lower the back knee, gently press the hip, we'll come through, outside hand, big reach, come back down, gently press that hip, come back through, outside hand reaches, back down, pressing that hip, and then inhale, opening up to the side. Good, planting that hand, we'll set those arms, straighten up the back leg. We'll step back into that down dog, setting the shoulders nice and strong so we're cozy up there. Press and hold the heel down. Press and hold the other heel. Back to center, lower the knees down to the floor. Setting yourself up in that table, we're gonna bring the toes together, separating the knees. We'll pull the hips back and down into that down, or so that's child's pose. Shoulders rolling away from each other. We're gonna take it over to the left side, reaching through that side body from the pinky all the way down to the hip. We're just gonna breathe into that sensation. So just breathe in through that
side body. Lengthening out that body a little bit. Next breath, we'll come back to center. Just giving ourselves a breath or two to reset those shoulders. Take a moment here. And we'll take it to the opposite side. Getting into that nice position. Reaching through that pinky all the way to the hip. And reset those shoulders, take a breath or two here, and then come back into that nice tabletop position, curling the toes under. We're going to walk up our quads, squeezing, set those hips, big breath up with the arms, we'll come down, we'll reach back and up, but focusing on the up, and then we'll exhale through, we'll reach back and up. Reaching back and up, and through, back and up, and through, a couple more, back and up, and back to your last one, inhale, reach back and up, and back through, good, big tall stretch up with both arms. Exhale those arms back down into our table. We're going to take our legs. We're going to swing them through. We're going to take a little seat. We're going to bring our feet flat. Our hands underneath the hamstring. We're going to roll the shoulders back and around the spine. Partway down. And then inhale, roll up. And then round the spine. Partway down. And then roll up. And then round all the way down as we walk the vertebrae down one by one, reaching the arms long. Draw the hands down the side of the body. We're going to walk the feet up. So they're just outside the fingers' reach. We're going to pull the ribs and sternum together so we get that nice little hollow position so our low back is against the floor. Take our arms up, palms face each other, reach them to the ceiling. We're going to push through the floor through those feet as we lift into our bridge. We're going to continue to push through those feet, reach through the shoulders as we breathe. Into that mid-body, out. Feel that side ab kick on. Inhale fully. Expand in that midsection, exhale. Lower the body down. The ribs are still in. We're going to take the palms facing towards the knee. Lower the arm down towards the floor. And come back up. We'll take the other side down. Come back up. Both arms down. And back up. Take the hands down. Inch off the floor. We make a little circle. Take them up the side. Palms rotate up, thumbs perhaps touching overhead. We'll come back down the side, palms rotate down. Again, up the side, palms rotate up. Thumbs perhaps touching. Come back down, palms rotate down. And one more time, inhale, palms rotate up. And then exhale, palms rotate down. From here, we'll join the toes and the heels together as we open up into our butterfly. Gently pressing into the floor, we're going to squeeze the glutes, lift the hips up a little bit off the floor and hold. Exhale, lowering those hips down, relaxing those hips, letting them sink down a bit. Squeeze, set, lift those hips up a bit. Exhale.
on the floor, so just a little hug. We're gonna inhale long and tall. Turning yourself into a big star, palms face up, arms relaxed, fingertips soft, toes relaxed. We're gonna take a big breath in through the nose. Exhale. Jaw to soften as we take that breath fully into the nose, allowing that in breath to fill the mid body, that whole midsection. And as we release, just allowing that softness to continue down the body, just taking a moment to allow that sense of relaxation to just consume your entire being. Inhaling, expanding. Exhaling, feeling that sense of release, just letting go. As we allow ourselves to kind of sink a little bit deeper into the mat or the floor. So we feel held, comforted, supported. And once we feel that sense of softness come over the entire body, just take that moment. Breathe in through the nose, again, noticing the slight coolness of the in-breath as it enters. That subtle pause that comes after the in-breath. That gentle release, that warmth of the out-breath on the nose. And that stillness, that sense of quiet that follows that release. Just experience the breath for what it is, this beautiful breath cycle, this life as we breathe it in and release all that is no longer necessary in this day. Just allow yourself to be with the breath, the in, that subtle pause, the out. Stillness. Embrace and observe the body and the mind as we lay in this moment with each and every breath as it comes and it goes. As we allow ourselves to experience that breath, we allow ourselves to let go of that experience as we ride that sweet wave of in and out, up and down, open and close. As we notice these breaths, remember it's completely normal for our mind to want to wander into other things perhaps that we have going on in our life or things we have to do today. Acknowledge these thoughts and these feelings, but don't attach yourself to them because your mind is doing what it's meant to do. But just instead of attaching yourself to those thoughts and feelings, acknowledge them and thank them for realizing that we are venturing away from the presence of the breath and allow that thought, feeling, task to bring you back to the breath, to bring you back to this place, this moment, so we can experience everything the breath has to offer. As we take that moment to breathe, to be, start to slowly breathe in our surroundings, the sounds, the environment around us, perhaps. Again, not attaching ourselves to any one sound or any one sensation, but just acknowledging your surroundings. Now notice the body, notice the feeling of the body in contact with the ground. Notice those points of contact. Notice perhaps the points that aren't in contact. And then use that breath to slowly wake the body, inch by inch, piece by piece. Fingers, toes, ankles, wrists, knees, elbows. Give yourself that moment to feel the body slowly wake with the in-breath as we reach those arms long and tall overhead. Exhale, drawing those knees in, rocking back and forth, slowly waking up the spine before rolling over to one side and just taking a breath here or two before joining me in a comfortable seated position. And as we sit together, breathing this beautiful breath of life, notice how you feel as you feel that in and the out. And take that lesson, that thought, that wherever you are in your day, in your life, the breath will always bring you back to here and now, regardless of what you have going on around you, within you. Use that breath to come back to center and to find grounding. Now as we open our eyes, thank yourself for taking this moment for you, and let me thank you for sharing this moment with me. Thank you so much, you guys, and I'll see you very, very soon.